stars, they're killing me. I don't know what you are, but I know what I need. The goodbyes, the lows, the I need you, no, I don't. Every time I start to close the door, you're not in that letter. Alone. Can you leave my watermelon alone? Stop. He wasn't even coming to mess with it. You ain't supposed to be messing with it.
All right, good morning. Sorry about the lighting. Happy Monday. I'm about to heat this coffee up. I got a grande, and I split it in half yesterday. It was just regular, like, dark roast coffee, because I think I need a new coffee maker. I don't know. I be cleaning it, but I feel like it's something stuck at the bottom on the inside, and I don't know. I don't have a brush to get deep down there, but my coworker had brought me this pistachio creamer, and for whatever reason, he had the audacity to bring me two. I don't want them to go to waste. Anyways, I got some leftover black coffee I'm about to heat up so that I can mix this and some vanilla syrup and make me a coffee before I take these dogs out to this dog park that I found. It's supposed to be hot today, like almost to the 90s. And by the time it's 11 o'clock, I think it's supposed to be like 86. And it's just barely after 7 now. So I'm trying to hurry up. And I'm feeding them, because usually now is about the time that they'll be eating, because we would have went for a walk already. But yeah, I'm about to take them to this park that I found in San Leandro. It's one in Redwood City I really want to take them to. But by the time we get there, it's just not going to make sense, since it's kind of a late start for us. So yeah, we're about to get ready to head out and do that, and then I guess I'll get my little coffee together. This is the syrup, this is vanilla syrup, and then this pistachio creamer, which is really good. If you're a fan of the sorry about the lighting too, because it's early in the morning, so I think it's just the window and all that being open. I have the light on. But anyways, if you like the pistachio latte that they had at Starbucks, it's not exactly the same, because I don't know what all they put in it, but you'll like this. It's really good. So I'm about to make my coffee. They're going to finish eating. We're going to head out, and then I'll pick you guys up when we get to the park.
Every second, every minute, man, I swear that she can get it. Say if you a bad bitch, put your hands up high. Hands up high, hands up high. Tell them dim the lights down right now. Put me in the mood. I'm talking about dark room perfume. Go, go.
I recognize your fragrance, hold up, you ain't never gotta say shit, and I know your taste is a little bit, high maintenance, everybody else basic, you live life on an everyday basis, with poetic justice, if I told you that a flower bloomed in a dark room, would you trust it? I mean, I write poems in these songs, dedicated to you and you're in the mood for empathy, it's blood in my pen. Better yet, with your friends and them, I really wanna know you all. I really wanna show you off. Fuck that, pour up plenty of champagne. Cold nights when you curse this name. You called up your girlfriends and y'all curled in that little bitty range. I heard that she wanna go and party. She wanna go and party. Nigga, don't approach her with that Atari. Nigga, that ain't good game, homie, sorry. They say conversation rule a nation, I can tell, but I could never write my wrongs unless I write it down for real. P.S.
So I'm out here looking a mess. It's hot, I'm sweating. I need my eyebrows arched. Primo's having the time of his life. Well, sir, that baby's hot. We ended up on a little mini hike. Going downhill wasn't so bad. It was coming up, but I carried Sir the way up because he was tired. I guess now Primo is. He's been running around while me and Sir have been waiting in the shade just to let Sir catch his breath because he's heavy. So we're not too far from the car. The rest is downhill from here, so it should be pretty easy. But this is our first time here, and this is a nice little park. I'll never do too much or push it with Sir, but this is definitely a good place for Primo. I know he enjoyed running around with his leash off, and this is actually a really good place for me to come run and get my steps in too, because I've been doing pretty good closing all three or at least two of my rings every day and just with my running and stuff. So this is definitely a challenge. It's a good place for me to come, especially before I start boot camp. But we're gonna head back to the car, and then I'll see you guys at some point. We literally made it back to the car, and this is where they decided to stop instead of jumping in. Y'all, we made it to the car. You guys can rest inside. Come on, buddies, let's get inside. I had to put towels down since when my car got stolen. They took my baby's car seats. Come on, buddies, let's get in the car. Okay, take turns. Okay, so we are back now from our walk, and I gotta say, I really enjoyed that trail. I just have a little small salad here. It's a little chicken, corn, and cheese that I got from Safeways, and I'm gonna get ready to cook dinner too and get that out the way, because I think I'm just gonna do some baked chicken, broccoli. I may or may not do like some rice or something with it, but baked chicken and broccoli for sure. And I want to get that out the way because I want to go run later. I have a place that I need to go look out. My lease is going to be up here in a few months, and I'm looking to move. So since baked chicken can kind of take a bit of some time, I just want to have that out the way. But that walk wore these dogs out. When I tell you, baby, they got in that car and laid down. I gave them some water, cutting that AC, and they were gone. Then we got back to the house, and they're still knocked out. Sir's over there laying on the rug. Primo is in his bed in the living room. I'll be trying to get all the little sauce up out of this. But, yeah, so that's pretty much... we got them out the way. I'm going wine tasting this weekend, and it's in Napa, and it's a 2-hour wine tasting. But then for Sam's birthday, we're also going to brunch immediately after. So that, and then having to go back, come back home, we'll be back around like maybe 5 or 6-ish. And I have to leave my house at, 8 something? It starts at 10:20. So it's kind of going to make it an all day thing. So I have to make sure I get them out all this week so that I don't feel bad about this weekend. Because I'm one of them type of moms. I don't want them to feel like they've just been put up and then they're put up that day. You know, so yeah. I'm gonna make sure I get them out all this week. I really have been wanting to take them to the beach too, but just, it's been so hot out here in Cali lately that sitting out in the sun, more so for Sir, just wouldn't be good. So I have to get something that we can sit in at the beach and have some sort of cover, like all my umbrellas and stuff that I had I had stuff in the trunk. So my car had gotten stolen recently when I was out of town in Vegas. And it's found now, but they didn't goddamn took literally everything that I had in it. My 360 stuff, like everything. I was out of town, so I left my house keys and stuff in the car. Nothing was out in the open. I don't know why they targeted my shit, but yeah, they literally took everything. So that's why I had towels on my seat today, instead of like them in their car seats. So I have to reorder a bunch of shit, but I'm gonna make sure I get them out all this week. I'm about to get ready. I'm gonna eat this salad. I'm gonna cut me some yellow watermelon. If you have not tried yellow watermelon, highly recommend. I don't even really buy a red watermelon no more since I tried that, but I almost fell. I'm gonna get ready to eat the salad. I'm gonna put my chicken in the oven to get that started. And that's pretty much it. I don't have much planned today other than going to look for a house and going for a run later. So yeah, I'll eat this and I'll talk to you guys later. I just had to come show y'all how good this look. If you have not tried yellow watermelon, also I had orange for the first time too at the farmer's market. So next time I'm gonna get me an orange one too. But I just got one because I didn't know if I would be able to eat them both before like one went bad. But I think I'm about to devour this between me and sir. Chipped two of his teeth. This top one looked like it's completely missing, and this bottom one looked chipped. I don't know what toy he was chewing on. All right, you guys, so it's the next day. Happy Tuesday. Today I almost pretty much slept the day away, other than when I got up this morning, went to the gym, got it in. I do want to go run later tonight, so I'm trying to cook now. I'm just making these cucumber boats that I saw on Instagram, but then I looked it up on YouTube. So I'm doing my shrimp, and I have a few that I'm going to fry, and then the rest I'm just going to put in some oil on the stove. And I have this Seafood Hidden Valley secret sauce that I got. I guess it's something new that they have. I don't know. Cut that on. So I'm just gonna make those for dinner, and I wanted to get that started so that I can be able to go for a run. I have my rice and the rice cooker, and yeah, I'll show you guys maybe as I'm building it. Let me season the shrimp. I'm just gonna do salt and pepper, maybe some onion powder, garlic powder, and then yeah, I'm just gonna put it on the stove in the oil, saute it, and I'll show you guys how I build it.
Second, every minute, man, I swear that she can get it. Say if you a bad bitch, put your hands up high. Hands up high. Hands up.
Sir, you scratching my leg. Here, go get your blue thing, Primo.
Sean, did you go give me a Tylenol or not?
Okay, you guys, so I'm back home. I just got clear pink on, is it focus? Okay, on my regular nails. I'm letting them grow out from the last time I got nails when I was just in Houston. And then just white on the toes. So I'm gonna have to go back and get my eyebrows arched tomorrow because the lady that arches eyebrows is not gonna be back until tomorrow. But I'm home cooking now, so I'm doing stuffed bell peppers tonight. I have some leftover broccoli, so I'm gonna do that. But really quick, let me know if you guys know about green sauce. This is my first, well, this is my like third or second time using this, but I couldn't find any in the store when I was like, I went to like literally 8 different stores. So I just ended up looking it up online and making my own. And so, yeah, I've just been trying to use that, but I'm just doing ground turkey. I have my bell peppers boiling now. It's not even 1 o'clock yet. I think it's almost 1, but I just kind of wanted to get dinner out the way because when I go running later, when I come back from running, y'all, I be, when I say starving, I be starving. Even if I eat like a little fruit or something, I'm comfortable. But when I go, by the time I come back, like I'm ready to eat. I'm ready to walk these dogs, feed them. I don't want to have to, you know what I mean, cook. So, yeah, I'm pretty much doing that. This is like my favorite little cup. I got this from, I think, Marshall's? Yeah. And it says dog mom to represent my baby. So, I drink my water out of this every day now. I was using this, which I do still love. My mom gave it to me, and I'll probably end up going back and forth. It definitely helps having like certain times to drink each part by, so it was like easier than I thought to drink this sorry, the spices. Okay, I don't even know how much this feels. 64 ounces. So I definitely made it easier, but this just represents my baby. So I got this, and yeah, I'm just about to finish cooking. It's hot as hell in here with this food on. That's another reason I want to start cooking, because it's been hot at night too, and I don't want it too hot in here later on. Like I have, this is the first place I have that doesn't have AC, but I have like all the fans and stuff on. Actually, I don't. I forgot to turn this one on when I came back, the bigger fan. Cause I'm like, why don't I feel any air? And I'm gonna open this back door. But yeah, I'm just cooking, and I'm, as soon as I open it, Primo went out there. he lived out there yesterday when I had the door open. But I'm just gonna finish cooking, and then I'm gonna try on this dress that I got from Fashion Nova. I ordered one from Micah's or Mika's, however you pronounce it, as well. That didn't come yet for wine tasting, so I'm praying to God that I can fit this one for the weekend. But let me show you guys the food. Okay, so I have 4 of these bell peppers going, and then this is the meat, the turkey meat. I added some onion and garlic to it, and I'm gonna do it kind of like I do my spaghetti a little bit. So I'm gonna add some garlic paste, a little bit of sriracha ketchup, and a little what do you call it? Oh, a little bit of barbecue sauce and a little tomato sauce that you use for your spaghetti. And then that's how I'm going to stuff the bell peppers. So this is what that's looking like. You can add more or less sauce if you want. Comment below and tell me how you make your stuffed bell peppers, if you make them. Sometimes I even add shrimp to it, but I used all my shrimp last night for the cucumber boats that I did. Well, I do have some more, but it's in the freezer frozen, so. Okay, so I cut the light off because it just seemed like it was better, but I'm pretty much building the bell peppers. So there's 4. I'm gonna give my mom 2 because I'm sure she's gonna come over and want some. So I put, my mom doesn't eat cheese, so hers is just gonna be the turkey meat and the rice mixed together. Mine is gonna be the turkey meat and the rice mixed together with some Parmesan cheese that I had. And I do have the sliced provolone cheese, so I might put some of that on top. But also I put these sweet hot peppers from Trader Joe's. If you know, you know, and if you don't, I feel bad for you. Okay, go get some. I have to buy like 3-4 jars at a time because I run through it. I put on everything, spaghetti and my egg whites, like literally it goes on whatever. I'll eat it with homemade french fries, like whatever. So I'm pretty much just building these, and I need to remember which two have the cheese piece on it so that I can put the cheese on top, so that when it's done, I have my oven already preheated, but so that when it's done, I don't forget the two that have the cheese in it. So I have two red, two green bell peppers. I'm gonna give my mom a red and a green, and I'm gonna take a red and a green. But yeah, we want to make sure I get the one with the cheese. And lately, honestly, I brought that flavor because I didn't see it in the vegan cheese, but I've been buying vegan cheese for like the past like year. But I had made, I think it's the Marry Me Chicken, and the recipe had called for shredded, what is that, Parmesan cheese. And they didn't have that flavor. So it was my first time. I've made it like two or three times since then recently because it was so good. I had to run it back. But yeah, it was my first time making it. And I just wanted the recipe to be, you know, as exact as possible. Everyone was talking about how good it was and how you have to try it. So I just wanted the recipe to be as exact as possible. So I went ahead and got the regular cheese. I'm not opposed to eating it. Like, I do eat it. But just if I'm cooking at home, you know, you try to make healthier choices or substitutes sometimes when you can, where you can, so that, you know, when you eat out or you eat at someone's house or something like that, you don't feel bad about, you know, what you're eating in that moment. So I'm just gonna top the top of mine. This is kind of almost gone, but I'm gonna use the rest of it and top it on top of mine so that we know whose is whose. And I just really, like I said, I wanted to get dinner out the way. I have some leftover broccoli, so I'll eat that with this tonight as well. That broccoli was really good. So yeah, this won't take long to bake in the oven. And then I also turn it on broil after the fact for a little bit, just for the sake of like my cheese, getting it a little brown and stuff. And then I'll probably take the dogs for their second walk. By then it should be time. Usually around like 2:30, I try to do that. And then their last walk is at 7. So let me get these bad boys put in the oven. And real quick, is it just me? So when I make things like bell peppers or whatever the case may be, like when I did the cucumber bolts last night and I took out the middle of the cucumber, like I still ate that. That's my microwave. But yeah, when I cut the top off of the bell peppers, I still, because I can use this in like my egg whites, or if you make like another meat or something, you put it in the oven or you want to saute it. I don't know. I just hate to waste it. I guess that's the culinary school in me. We wasted so much food, but yeah. Ow, you're scratching my leg, baby. Here. All right, y'all. Happy Wednesday. This is my last day looking semi-raggedy. I'm about to go get my eyebrows arched. I'm gonna get my nails and my feet done. I think I'm just gonna get white on my toes and clear pink on my nails, because I'm going to a winery. I'm going to Napa for wine tasting this Sunday, and I brought a new dress and all of that, so I just want to make sure, you know, my nails and everything are up to par for picture sake and things of that nature. But first, I came to Star Bread. If you have never had Senorita bread, you're missing out. Somebody at my job at the refinery used to bring it to me every Friday, and I haven't had it in a while. Now I'm like addicted. Well, I've been addicted since he introduced me to it. The location I'm at, though, I much rather like the location by my job, because I don't know, there's just better to me. They're all fresh and made daily, but this one I feel like is missing something. Like, it's not as sweet or something, I don't know, but it's still getting pretty soft, so I'm about to, oh Lord, I'm about to run to Starbucks, get a coffee, and then we're gonna head to the nail shop. All right, you guys, so I am, I think, gonna end this video out today, but real quick, I just came back from a holistic store that I go to in Richmond. I just want to show you guys some stuff that I got. I just realized I actually did need to get these. So I got these organic sea moss capsules, and it says to take 2 capsules in the morning and 2 before bed. Up to 6 capsules a day can be used. So I got these little tablets, if you guys can see, because I can't do the regular powder sea moss. My mom can. I know people who can do it. The taste is disgusting. I tried the gel. The texture and the fucking taste is disgusting, so I have to do the capsules. But the guy had this tangerine sea moss gel as well. So ingredients, Tanzanian sea moss, 100% tangerine juice, 2 to 3 tablespoons a day, and keep refrigerated. So this is what it looks like. It's from the holistic store. He said, because I was telling him that I suffer from migraines since I was small, and I know Tabitha Brown, I got her book, and she was saying that she has as well. Let me just show her book off real quick. She said that she suffered from migraines since she was a child as well, and they both said the same thing. The doctors didn't know what was causing it, was never able to do anything that would help. The medication they would be given when they were hospitalized and stuff, like over the counter, nothing ever worked. So she said that it helped her migraines went away when she completely changed her eating. I somewhat have. There's a lot of things that I cut out, but I'm not there yet to completely give up like all meats and completely do like raw diet. I'm just not there yet. And to be honest, I don't know if I'll ever be, but you know, I'm trying. I'm doing what I can. And then for him, he was saying that it can also be vitamin and like mineral deficiency. So like I take my vitamins, but the minerals that our body needs, he was saying that once he started taking the right amount of sea moss that he needed, and I think he also doesn't like eat meat and stuff, but once he started taking the amount of sea moss and stuff that he needed per day, his migraines went away. So that's what made me say, okay, I'll go ahead and try this flavored one. Now, he did let me try it in the store before I buy it. He was like, if you don't like it, I'll just take it. But I just went ahead and bought it. This was for $30. And I still don't like it, y'all. I ain't gonna hold you. But it's a lot more tolerable. So between the two of these right now, you know, I'm hoping that would help. Also, I take these vitamins I take for it, which have helped a lot, but I had kind of been lacking the past few weeks, which explains why I probably had a headache for the past 2 days. Let me take this meat off real quick. Okay, so yeah, basically, I forgot where I left off, but he was saying that once he started taking sea moss in the right amount, so 1 to 2 tablespoons, so we'll see. And then, oh, the vitamins I take for my headache that work that I haven't been taking lately was magnesium. So with the combination of all of that, hopefully it should help with my migraines and just, you know, all the minerals and stuff that I need. I know there's 102 that the body needs, and I think sea moss gives 98 or 99. There's something that gives 102, but I forgot the name of it. They had that as well, but I just went ahead and got the sea moss right now. And then also, I have been taking chlorophyll, and I was asking him like what he thinks about that. And chlorophyll, he was saying, is good. He was just like, to make sure, because I got mine, I order it off Amazon, and he was saying to just make sure that it's not coming from like broccoli or like man-made foods. And I was like, I don't know where it's coming from, but while I'm here, let me just go ahead and get some of what you have. And I'm pretty sure this is going to be a lot more potent because it's a lot darker But ingredients for he is, if I butcher something,
egg.
Okay. But marine photoplankton, I think it is. Basil, cilantro, chlorella, spirulina, moringa, stinging nettle, sea moss, bladder wrack, linden leaf, bitter leaf, and kelp. And so one full drop into your water daily, and then if you're giving it to your kids, 5 drops per ounce. Children, 5 drops ounce per day in water or juice. I don't know. But 5 drops, I guess, maybe per 8 ounce or something. I don't know. But anyways, yeah, so I got some of these. These are the same thing, chlorophyll. So yeah, I just wanted to show those off. I'm back, you know. I'm working out twice a day. I'm either taking the dogs for a hike or going to the gym, plus my run in the afternoon. I did not go today because of my headache, even though I did still take them on the hike, and it didn't go away. But I do plan on going to the gym tomorrow, so hopefully my head feels better. And yeah, I don't know. I'm drinking my water. I'm, you know, adding my chlorophyll, and I'm just going to try to stay consistent. And these sea moss that I'm about to put in the fridge, it's going to be disgusting, but I'm going to take it with some, you know, juice. And I told him I juice sometimes stuff too, so he said I can definitely mix it with that or a smoothie or whatever the case may be to help kind of hide the taste. I took some at the store, but I'm going to take a teaspoon tomorrow with, I don't know, some watermelon juice or something along those lines. So anyways, I'm about to finish cooking. I'm going to take these dogs for their last walk of the day. I'm going to eat and finish watching Dexter on Netflix. And I'm going to call it a night. Call it a day. Something else I'm trying to get consistent with is with this vlogging stuff. I'm just going to try to stay consistent with everything in life that I'm doing right now. I've been doing pretty good running, getting ready for this boot camp that I'm getting ready to start. I'm just going to try to, you know, be consistent with everything all the way around. I hope somebody enjoyed this vlog. And, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye. Just look how beautiful it is out here. We're out on another hike, and we're at the same place we were, 2 days ago? And it's so funny because I didn't get to show it, but we saw Primo's twin the last time we were out here, and they just both, oh, he's going to the bathroom again. Come back, we got to pick up after him. Okay, anywho, we saw Primo's twin out here, and we were like wondering if they came from like the same litter, because we both, like, I got mine through my brother, like, we both don't know where we got them from, but they were the same age and they were twins. And then today we saw Sir's twin, and they were also the same age. He was also a miniature, so I thought that was dope.
Come and take your place, 'cause the love you give, you can't be replaced. So go now, like you do. That's why I'm spending my life with you. I wanna please you in any way I can. I wanna share my world, don't you understand? Your love is a one in a million. It goes on.
Right, that's fine.
will be the perfect collection.
You need him, a strong man. You don't need nobody that much better.
Like rats, snakes, spiders.
That's how I am with them rodents.
Yeah, reptiles.
Here is a cage where I can put the person that was tortured here, and we can put this in the courtyard. So everybody will see what happens if you betray the king. Also, you're gonna be eaten by the birds.
I'm sorry.
Be very dry and really good with seafood. I'm gonna explain more about this one in the next round.
Oh, is this coming next round?
Yeah.
Okay.
Lady diamonds hitting, turn the flash off. I'm like Winn Dixie, I get bags off. Baby got a pretty face, slim waist, ass off. I'ma get my own sack, bitch, I never had the bag. I ain't taking shit back, bitch, I said what I said. I was down bad, and they left your boy for dead. She said, girl, that fat nigga keep a loaf of bread. We got powerhouses coming through on mopeds. I'ma still run and check up like I got a full leg. Give me any drug, I'ma get it home. I'ma stop on these fuck niggas every time they piss off. Bitch, I'm tryna score, I ain't got no time to punt. I'm filling up my slap wood with Obama runs. Throw me the alley hoop, yeah, yeah. Bitch, threw me the alley hoop, I fucked around and dunk. Got the small talk, I like cash talk. Lady diamonds hitting, turn the flash on. I'm like Winn Dixie, I get bags off. Baby got a pretty face, slim waist, ass off. I'ma get my own sack, bitch, I never had the bag. I ain't taking.